Welcome back to my channel. In this video, I am going to explain how to enter gstr2a entries in TallyPrime. These are the model entries. So how I have entered this is here, this is the purchase template, Excel template. This I will provide in the description. You can use this. Year date, the transaction date, this is the date I have entered. Okay, then here the voucher type is purchase. Okay, voucher number, this is the voucher number. These are the voucher numbers. Okay, then here for the first entry, I have entered in two lines because it's a exempted purchase. So party account credit and purchase account debit, that's it. So the first one is this, you know, 0%, tax rate is nil. So this and this, so that I entered twice, that is debit and credit. First to enter this amounts in this column where this is ledger amount. Okay, debit or credit, party account always credit. See here also credit, here also credit. Then purchase account and tax ledgers comes debit. Here this is the purchase account, 5% is debit and IGST is debit. And the third entry is local CGST, SGST. So that here I entered in four lines. So this is the party amount credit, then taxable value debit, CGST debit, SGST debit. 1, 2, 3, 4. So that is why you have to enter four lines here. If you have the all ledger names in your tally, there is no need to create this master. So that is called a ledger. One more sheet is ledgers. Here I have taken this party name and purchase exempted, purchase ledger is a must. Then CGST, SGST. Here I have entered twice, it is not required, so one is enough. CGST, SGST. Here two times I have entered, it is not required. So we can delete this. Alt-ED. Then here also there are two entries, purchase account. So ledger name is, you have to create only once. So you can delete this names. Okay, these are the parties. Three entries, only two parties, because I will explain you. Here, you know, this is the same party. One, and this is one. So that's why two parties under sundry creditors. Sundry creditor, this one. Sundry creditor, this one. Purchase, there are two purchase, that is one exempted purchase, then 5% purchase, CGST 2.5, SGST 2.5. This is the tax ledgers. So this comes under duties and taxes. This comes purchase accounts. Party accounts While entering purchase vouchers, the party ledger comes under sundry creditors. Please note this point. Purchase account that is exempted or taxable 5%, 12%, 18%, whatever it is, the purchase ledger comes under purchase accounts. IGST, CGST, whatever it is, that comes under duties and taxes. Okay, so there is no doubt at all. Now come to this. So these are the entries I made: 470, 16,101, 14,796. Here 471, and one more is 16,101. Then 14,796. Corresponding ledgers are purchase account, CGST, SGST. So these three are debit. These two are debit. Why this entry comes only three means, that is purchase and IGST. There is no CGST, SGST. Here only two entries, debit and credit, because it is exempted. There is no tax. So it is clear, you know. Now we will go for tally. Here this is the company. There is no vouchers. See, you can check. There is no entries. Even though I will show you the trial balance, there is no entries. Ledgers, I don't have any ledgers, account books, ledgers, so only cash and profit and loss account, these two are default ledgers. Now I am going to import ledgers and vouchers, vouchers from this accounting voucher sheet, and ledger is from ledger sheets. I am going to import here. So this file, this Excel file have been stored in this location, that is C drive, TallyPrime 4 temp. Okay, now we are going to import ledgers and vouchers. Go to Tally. So there is no vouchers, there is no ledgers. Please be careful in this screen. Click on import. First masters, because of there is no ledgers in my tally, so that I am going to import masters. Masters file format is Excel. File location. File location C tally. Prime 4 and temp. This is the location. C drive, TallyPrime, temp. Okay. Then the file name is purchase.xls. File name purchase.xls. Okay. Then enter. Enter. Sheet name is ledger, because of masters I have created in ledger sheet. Okay, don't confuse. File name is purchase. Master sheet is ledger, and purchase vouchers is accounting voucher. There is no doubt, you know. So here sheet name I have enter as ledger. Default. Okay. Okay. Please note this. No need to play. You can take this screenshot also. Okay. Here, ignore duplicate. You can take this section always. Report summary, yes. So three ledgers has been updated. Click on import. See here, import completed successfully. Now we will check the ledgers whether it is imported or not. Successfully imported. Now we are going to take import vouchers. There is no vouchers. Now click here import, then transactions, same Excel sheet, purchase, then here the first sheet, you know, accounting voucher, this sheet I have to select. This readme, that is only the notes, and ledger, this is the master. So we are going to import purchase voucher, so that select accounting voucher. Okay. Purchase entries 3. Now you can click here import. Import successfully. Now we will check that vouchers whether it is correct or not. Yeah, first one is this one, I think. 470, date 23. Yeah, it's fine. Then one more entry. 14,796. 14,796. Taxable value is 14,091,352,352. I will show you. 14,091 is the taxable. CGST, SGST. And one more entry. 16,101. And taxable 15,333. IGST is 768. So this is the bill value, and this is the taxable, and this is the IGST. Thank you for watching this video. Please don't forget to share this video with your friends. Thank you.